How would you like to effortlessly mash the ball to your target with great feeling contact, doing some simple little trick that I'm going to show you in today's episode? I'm talking about something in the setup that's going to get you hitting nice, clean, crispy golf shots like this. Ooh, that felt amazing. And you're going to feel that level of amazing when we pay attention to something just as simple as your grip. And yes, it's a little grip tip that will get you to hit shots that feel just as amazing as that one. I see a lot of golfers, when it comes to the grip, they just sort of grip it however they feel like. They don't give much thought to it. And when I look at their golf swings, the golf swings are inconsistent because of a bad grip. So a good grip is one that is secure and allows for a repeatable golf swing. A bad grip is one that, well, it's insecure. It could wobble around your hands, so it means your swing could break down. Actually, grips can cause breakdowns in your swings. The club face could rotate depending on how insecure the grip is. And the worst part of all, contact just doesn't feel great when your grip is insecure. You don't get that buttery mash feeling. I want you to have that buttery mash feeling because it's so much fun as part of playing golf. So if your grip's insecure, you might see things like this in your swing. You might see that your arms break down, your wrists have to go beyond parallel like this. You might see through impact, you're flipping and scooping your wrists like this. So you're losing power. Your swing is different every time. So how can you hit the ball in the same spot every time? Well, you really don't know. This simple little trick gets rid of all of those variables and gets you to hit amazing golf shots every single time. What I want you to do is think about what your trail hand is doing on the club. So your right hand, if you're a right-handed player. When you grip the club, give some more thought to this. Your grip needs to be secure. And why does it need to be secure? So you can have the same swing every single time. Not only that, this hand right here, you see that thumb on your lead hand? I don't want to see it anymore. I want us to secure up your grip. So this pressure point between the right hand and the left hand needs to be covered up and firmed up. Now what's going to happen when you do this, you're going to start feeling like your grip is much more secure than it was before. And the grip pressure, you're holding it nice and firm. Not like a baby bird, but nice and firm, and here's why. If I keep a firm hold on the club, as I swing back, you're going to find that your wrists, which is a power source, they hinge up naturally, creating this beautiful angle right here. And you might find that your lead arm stays nice and straight, which helps you with contact. So that's two for one right there already. Now coming into impact, this pressure point, which is so magical, is going to store power. There it is. It's going to keep lag, as it's often called. So store power here. And then through impact, because you have this pressure point, it's going to allow you to hit down and through the golf ball. So you're going to be able to create a nice divot on the front side of the ball and do that every single time. That's the key for clean, consistent contact. So you might be thinking to yourself, well, my grip feels really secure and it feels different. Good. Good. It means that your grip was probably insecure before. So next, when you got this secure grip, we need to hit some golf shots. We're not going to jump right into hitting a million balls as fast as we can. Now we got to start nice and slow. With a firm grip, do about a 20% swing, feeling what it's like to have a secure hold on the club, and make little shots just like that. That was crispy ball first, then a nice little divot on the front side of it. We can't rush into perfection. We have to get used to the feel first. Hit a few like that in your practice session. Take it back, secure hold, good contact. I'm finding that holding the club nice and secure like this is really allowing me to hit the ball first, take a nice divot on the front side of it. You hear the sound of that impact. I'm barely swinging, the ball is just boom, right off the club face. Then once you've done that, we can graduate up into some fuller swings. Same idea here though. Nice firm hold on the club, secure, keeping it secure. You're thinking about pressure point here. Don't see that thumb and just swing. Buttery mashed potatoes right there. That felt so good. And then we do it again because that feels awesome. And really all I'm thinking about is keeping that pressure point secure in my swing. So I'm not thinking a lot about my swing because this piece right here takes care of a lot of your golf swing. And that's awesome. How many of you have too many swing thoughts? I know who you are out there. I can see you raising your hands right now. You're like, I do think too much over the ball. This will get you thinking a lot less over the ball. Secure hold on the club, firm grip. Good contact. Oh. And not a whole lot of effort, because like I said, this pressure point is keeping the power stored here and through impact. It's keeping the golf swing simple. Left arm straight, power stored, explosion of power through impact. So you're not doing a whole lot of work. You can do that with one simple little tip right here in this video. So as you're working on this, you're going to start hitting some crispy golf shots. But as you move forward, you're going to need something to help you keep the crispiness going. Ooh. That's why I recommend you check out my online golf school, Saguto.golf. It's a complete golf game training program designed to help you build up your swing and keep it in fine working condition so you can keep this beautiful shot after shot contact rolling. I've got a link in the comments and description below to help you continue. Hit the ball first, take nice divots on the front side of the golf ball. This simple little tip, if it helped you play better golf, comment below, like this video. Share with golfers you think need the help. And you can click here to join my online golf school. Click here to subscribe. And here are two awesome selections from the Saguto Golf Archives designed to help you play your best golf right now. Remember, life is far too short to play bad golf. So let's get on the train to playing the best golf of your life right now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in a future episode.